A couple of videos ago, I created an underwater 3D scene. I did the entire thing in Blender, even the post-processing for the sake of Blender users. But originally, I exported the sequence with the view transform set as film log to have the best dynamic range, and then I color graded the footage in DaVinci Resolve, a free editing software that has super powerful color grading tools. Hello everyone, how are you? I'm Luciana, this is my YouTube channel 24 Horses Per Second, and today I'm gonna explain some concepts while showing you how to color grade your log 3D footage in DaVinci Resolve. First and foremost, what is a log and why use it? Log footage is flat footage that contains more details of the scene. It preserves the maximum amount of image data for manipulation during the color correction process. If you have a high contrasted image and wanting to lower the contrast, you have no information in your image to do it. But with a log image, you can increase and decrease the contrast without losing quality. Log footage is great for flexibility in workflow and for making high quality adjustments. This is not a format intended for visualization, but for post-processing. Okay, but why not just color grade on this footage? Why a log footage that looks all washed out, when we have other options that give us our render ready to upload without post-processing? Well, usually renders don't look their best without some editing. Maybe there's only one object in your render that is a bit over or underexposed, and adding or subtracting a light in the 3D software changes the whole scene. So you can mask that object in post-processing and change its exposure a bit. Or maybe it looks a bit warmer than you want to, so you can cool it down with tools that are specific for that task. And not to mention using the tools that software like DaVinci Resolve offer, not only for basic color correction but also for creative color grading, very difficult to achieve in a 3D software, like adding a color tint to the shadows or highlights, for example. Let's start making a new project and naming it. I'm gonna use the same settings as my 3D render. Now we need to make a timeline in our project, and I'm gonna leave the settings as my project settings. Let's go to the editing tab, and I'm gonna import my footage as an image sequence. Drag it to the timeline. And of course, in my original project, I also added the dust as an image sequence. Let's go to the color tab. The first thing we're gonna do is normalizing the footage and making some basic corrections. Normally, you will normalize the footage in one node or in the color management tab, and in another node, you will do the basic corrections. This is a node, and then we'll be adding more color nodes for each color adjustment. So we need to convert this washed out image our monitor cannot read into an image our monitor can display. And that will be the base for the color grading we're gonna do later. In this case, I'm gonna use the color wheels for this matter, and with these ones, we can change brightness, contrast, and color. The lift, gamma, and gain controls broadly correspond to the dark, mid-range and bright regions in the image. The master wheel controls below the color balance controls adjust brightness in the lift, gamma and gain regions. I'm gonna lower my mid-tones. Increase contrast. Adjusting the lift wheel will increase or decrease brightness in the darker areas. Increase the gain a bit. I wanted less brightness in the highlights and in the background. And we're gonna achieve that with secondary color correction. Secondary color correction is targeting a portion of the frame or isolating a subject with a mask or with qualifiers. Add the serial node. You can change the name of each node. In this case, I'm gonna decrease the brightness in the highlights because I think they are a bit overexposed for the look I had in mind. For that, I'm gonna use the qualifiers, and with these controls, we're gonna change the mask according to the color, saturation, and luminance. I already know the values I want because I already color graded this footage, so I'm just gonna write these values. Here you can see how the mask is going. The gray area is the unmasked portion. You can also visualize the mask clicking the wand. And now I'm gonna decrease the brightness using the color wheels. This change is only going to affect the bright purple we mask. Mute this node to see the changes, and before all changes and after. Add the serial, add a layer node, in this node, I'm gonna separate this blue background from the anemone using again the qualifier tool. Again, I'm gonna change the settings to set the mask as I want it. Thank you. For the purples, gonna use the bars, which essentially are the same as the color wheels. See how the mask works? Gonna lower the brightness. I want my anemone to have a bit less of green and less saturation. Mute the snow to see the changes. And now the background. Gonna lower the red a bit and add a bit of blue. Let's mute the background node before, after, and the purples node before and after. Now the curves, which are another way of controlling the brightness and the amount of red, green, and blue. Gonna lower the midtones and the blacks. For my final adjustment, gonna sharpen a bit my image because I think it's a little blurry. And that's it. Mute this node to see the changes. And before all changes, and after. Now we just need to export this into a video, and DaVinci has a couple of templates for that. I usually choose YouTube, so I'm gonna go to the YouTube tab and then back to custom. So now my project has the YouTube settings, but I can also change anything from the settings. I'm just gonna change the file output as an MP4 and the resolution. And that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it. Let me know if you would like a more in-depth video about color grading. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!